For the longest time, my buddy Jonathan and I have been trying to hike one of the biggest hikes in New York. It's been a dream of ours since we can remember because we both never had enough time to make the trip. But then all of a sudden, our schedules finally aligned for a short weekend. The fall colors were still looking amazing, so we made our move. Now it was time to start planning this hike. There are two huge hikes that we really wanted to do in the Adirondacks, but we had to pick one because we had limited time. We compared both hikes on the map and did research to find out which one would be best worth our time. Next, it was time to pick what trails we wanted to hit and what spots we wanted to shoot at. Now that we figured out where we wanted to go, we had to figure out what we needed to prepare for this huge hike. We started creating a couple of lists. First, we started with the shopping list for food. We needed food that was going to be easy to eat out in the middle of the woods, and something that would also not attract bears. So Jonathan made some grilled chicken, and we went to the store and got some bars and snacks.
Just waxed it. Look at these. Look at these. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. I even got hydraulics. Yeah.
After we figured out what food we needed, we had to figure out what camera gear and hiking gear we wanted to bring. I ended up ordering a tent on Amazon so we could camp out overnight. Jonathan ordered a hiking backpack, but unfortunately his backpack didn't deliver in time, so we had to rig something up. When we got all the gear packed and put in the car, it was 4:30 in the morning, and now it was time to get on the road and head north.
Yo, yo.
Is it recording?
Yeah, we're live. Right here. Getting into the truck. 4:34. Alec driving the Jetta.
I'm a Jedi now.
Driving the Jetta. Jetta's in the Jedi. So, we're starting our 5-hour trip right now. And I have an accounting problem to do. So I have my notebook right here. Alec is graciously going to start this drive so I can get this homework done. We'll check in. We are closer to Canada.
Yeah, let's just keep going towards Canada.
Towards that Canadian bacon.
We drove for a total of 6 hours, and when we finally got there, our plans were ruined. We were talking to one of the park rangers, and he was telling us that you cannot camp at the location that we wanted to due to it being private property. So we decided that we might have to find another spot, but luckily we still had the other spot in mind. So we decided to go to that one. So we've just got to our first location. Actually, this isn't even our first location. We were on our way to one of the trails, and we saw this amazing view. So yeah, so we stopped because we saw this amazing view, and I figured it'd be a good idea to just get the race drone up in the air real quick, get a cool low shot over the field there and up over the trees. I got my new long range setup, so I should be able to go pretty far with it. Yeah, we're going to a different spot than we were originally gonna go to. Actually, the original spot we were gonna do was the one I did in my first vlog that I did with Issa. But this time we're doing something a little different because apparently you can't camp over there. So we want to camp, so we found a different spot that's pretty much just as cool, might be even cooler, but we're gonna camp over there. But so right now we're just gonna fly the race drone and get some cool shots. Finally got to the spot, but by that time it was already midday and we had wasted a lot of time figuring out our backup plan. But we were still dedicated to doing this hike as we were already there, and we finally made it after a long time of trying to make these hikes happen. And so we decided to start the hike anyways, but first we were told that we need a special bear canister to hold our food and that it's required by the DEC. They told us we can rent one inside, so we rented one and started our hike.
No one can tell me that you would be mine. I can't believe my eyes tonight.
Alright, so we made it to our first location. Made it to this dam. Beautiful scenery. Been hiking for about an hour. Just got to this spot. Two more big ones until we're there. Stay tuned.
Just can't fight it. Oh, oh, oh. Just wanna show you paradise. the light. Show you the light. Show you the light.
We walked a total of 6.5 miles at a super fast pace to try to beat the sundown.
We finally made it to our camping spot just in time for the sunset, so we decided to set up our tent right away.
Once the tent was set up, we went and watched the rest of the sunset from a bridge that crosses over the lake. We also ate our food over there and met some really cool people while we were hanging out there eating.
Then we decided to go back to the tent and get some sleep because the night before we had pulled an all-nighter and we were super tired after walking all those miles, but it was only 7:30 p.m., so we couldn't sleep.
Alright, what's up guys? So we finally made it to a spot to camp out. It feels like it's freaking 1 a.m. We've been hiking all day.
It is 7:30. It took us 5 hours to get here. But it was beautiful.
Nice scenic walk.
Some good grilled chicken.
We're gonna have some footage. We're working on it. We'll see what we could get. But yeah, so the plan is we're gonna get up early in the morning and pack it all up and get out of here right before the sun's even up. So that's the plan. I'll see you guys soon.
Just can't fight it. Just let me be the one to hold you tight. Show you the light now. I want to treat you right every night. Show you the
next morning, as soon as the sunrise, we decided to pack things up right away and get moving. We made it to that bridge again, and we were just stunned with the view and decided to shoot for a little bit. So I decided to fly the FPV race drone first, but unfortunately my GoPro froze and we lost the footage. But we also got a couple of shots with my other cameras that looked amazing, so we weren't too upset.
Yo, look at the sunrise, dude. Bro.
Dude, look at that sun.
So we got the SanMark DJI Osmo Action Filters. I actually have had these for a little bit. I still haven't gotten to test them out, so I'm really excited to test them out right now. So we're gonna pop them on the Osmo Action, get some cool shots with it, and see how it comes out. All right, so we just woke up, we packed everything up. We're still right by the campsite. The camp's like right around the corner right there. We stopped at this bridge to get some cool shots, and we're heading on our way out. We're gonna get some cool shots on the way out though, so stay tuned, I guess. Wow, look at this amazing view. What's that I see? Is that a wild Jonathan? Wow, we're out here in the wilderness. Oh, he's doing his mating call. We might see another one come soon.
Gourmet breakfast right here, some go-go pouch, and some Fakear. Hiker's delight.
We just hiked about an hour and a half, right?
Yep.
And yeah, we figured just stop, get some food out, take some layers off, and get back at it and eat on the way.
Save the bears.
Or no, that's not to save the bears. It's to save us,
it's
honestly.
Save the bears.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
Oh, save the bears. Okay, we're saving bears, I guess.
Saving bears, not even trying.
The chocolate chip Cliff Bar. Honestly, I've never had a Cliff Bar. I'm really excited to try it finally.
These are so good. I would sponsor these. Go-Go pouch, fruits and vegetables.
No, they're supposed to sponsor me. That's how it works around here.
split it up.
Alright guys, so we were just hanging out here for a little bit. We've been on our way back. We just stopped to eat something and I just flew the race drone. I flew it low down the river and up and around there. It was some awesome shots that I got of these mountains and everything. So I can't wait to show you guys.
Your hair's a mess.
12 mile hair. That's what 12 miles looks like.
So what's the plan?
Now, we are gonna go head an hour or two to Glen Falls and then to go see Jules. So, yeah. Jules, we're coming to get you, taking you home.
And if any of you who don't know who Jules is, that's my sister. Yeah, she goes to school up here, so we're gonna visit her. Fix them broken lights till we get it right and pain falls to the past. Time could run us out, so our hearts got settled down. Yes, time could run us out, so we'll find out, yeah, we'll find our common ground. Yes, time could run us out, so we'll find out. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking three separate photos, one panned down, one forward, and the other one panned a little up. And basically what that does is that's how I make a, basically I call it a portrait panorama. Because now you can go to Photoshop and you can stitch it all together and make it one portrait shot without sacrificing any quality, like what would happen when you crop an image. So our hearts got settled down. Yes, time could run us out, so we find. Alright guys, so we're driving back and we just decided to stop at this lake. I passed this lake a couple times and I've just been, every time I've been here, I'm just like, damn, I gotta fly the drone here. And I never do, so the colors are looking insane right now and it's just beautiful here. I'm gonna do it. We stopped, we're doing it now.